What counts as a bedroom? The total number of bedrooms is an important selling feature of any home, so it's no wonder that many homeowners are eager to transform extra rooms into bedrooms. But did you know there are legal definitions and coding requirements for bedrooms? The number of bedrooms in your home can have a major impact on your home value and even your property taxes, so it's important to learn the rules on what rooms actually qualify. Remember, legal definitions can vary across states and municipalities, so always be sure to check on the requirements in your specific area. Here are several common requirements used to determine if a room qualifies as a bedroom. Size requirements. The actual size requirements of a bedroom vary by location, but in many cases, the minimum requirement is between 70 and 80 square feet. So 70 square feet is about 8 feet by 9 feet, and 80 square feet is about a 9 foot by 9 foot room. If a room in your home is smaller than the minimum size requirement, you'll likely need to advertise it as a small office, a closet, or a bonus room. In addition to total square feet, your bedroom must also measure at least 7 feet horizontally. The height of the ceiling also matters. At least half of the ceiling must be higher than 7 feet. In other words, if your ceiling is slanted, which is common in lofts or attic spaces, make sure at least half of its area meets the minimum height requirement. Exit points. Requirements in many locations specify that a bedroom should have 2 points of exit. While 2 doors may qualify in some cases, many places require at least 1 exit point to be a window or a skylight. To qualify as a bedroom, there must be 2 ways in which a person can exit the room to ensure there is safety in the event of a fire. Window size. Many places have minimum size requirements for windows. A common rule is that the total glass area of the window be at least 8% of the floor. Windows also shouldn't be higher than 44 inches, which is about 3.5 feet above the floor, and they must be at least 5.7 square feet or 2 feet by 3 feet to qualify. Again, it's to ensure that a person can exit the room to ensure safety in the event of a fire. Heating and cooling. Common in areas that experience hot summers or cold winters are heating and cooling requirements. To qualify in certain areas, bedrooms must be temperature controlled. This is especially common for master bedrooms. In most cases, the heat source needs to come from an HVAC system or furnace. While space heaters and fireplaces are often used, they don't qualify as the required heat source. They can be additions, but they cannot be the only heat source. Remember, buyers love to imagine what they can do with extra space. So if you have a room that doesn't quite qualify as a bedroom, you can always get away with advertising it as an office or a nursery or even a bonus room. Even if it's not technically a bedroom, extra rooms are always a great selling point. Turning extra rooms into bedrooms can be beneficial for numerous reasons, but always be sure to make sure your space meets the legal requirements in your area before labeling it as a bedroom. Make sure if you are advertising it as a bedroom, it meets the legal requirements for your area. Some common areas that need to be reviewed include size requirements, the total square footage, minimal horizontal restrictions, and ceiling restrictions, exit points, including doors and windows, window size, area for the glass, minimal square footage, and height from the floor, and of course, heating and cooling. The main source for heat and cooling cannot be from a space heater or fireplace. I hope you have found this video to be helpful and informative to help you determine if that room can be tagged as a bedroom or if it must be labeled as an office or a bonus room. Be sure to like this video so others can have access to this insight for bedroom requirements. Share it with a friend who could learn the inside value of knowing if a room is bedroom worthy or not, whether they're buying or selling. It's good to know. And leave comments below of some restrictions you were not aware of or some changes you made to make sure our room qualified as a bedroom so we can continue the conversation. Be sure to subscribe to my channel for more real estate insight and home ownership success tips from my home to yours.